I think we're looking at it the wrong way. I think we need to have a conversation about compassion and a conversation about humanity. You know, fearing for your life is not a political stance. Having an empty stomach is not a political opinion. This is just part of being human. If there's people out there listening to us who thinks that everybody should wait in line, you should know that this line that we're supposed to wait on is completely disregarded by our government. And it is rarely a viable option for people who are fleeing for their lives. If we are going to ask for accountability from those who act illegally, we need to ask of that from our own government. Try to imagine for a moment that the only way to save your 8-year-old son from being recruited into a gang is to risk being separated from him. Imagine being in the shoes. Someone I met in Tijuana was a transgender woman named Sharon. She was seeking asylum because her own transphobic father tried to kill her. She showed me the scars on her legs and arms from the stab wounds inflicted while she was still a teenager. Would you tell that person to wait in line?
Fuck no.
Lex was talking about a reunification he witnessed. This was a young man named Brian. Last January, Brian spent his 19th birthday at the Otay Mesa Detention Center in San Diego when he was caught crossing into the U.S. to escape death threats in Guatemala. He was threatened and harassed for defending his mother when he saw her boyfriend beat her up. He was followed one evening, last December, he was followed by two men who put a gun to the back of his head. Brian's life was spared by the grace of a faulty gun that three times refused to fight.
Excuse me?
Brian ran away and he spent last Christmas on a bus somewhere between Mexico City and Tijuana. When he was detained by U.S. immigration, our government attempted to profit from his and his mother's suffering and set his bail at $25,000. An immigrant, a refugee, who fulfilled all of the credible fear requirements, who did not have a criminal record, $25,000 to get out. He was lucky. He was lucky to have a very good lawyer who lowered his bail to $1,500. But he was one of the very few lucky ones that get out. Most people are detained and they don't know when they're getting out. I met a person who was in a detention camp for 2 years who finally gave up and signed a voluntary deportation order. 2 years in a detention camp. So, I want us, next time that we're having a conversation about immigration, I want to urge you not to frame it as a political conversation. We tend to think that talking about politics is difficult. We don't want to talk about politics on the Thanksgiving table or at the dinner table. But we're not going to talk about politics. We're going to talk about compassion, and we're going to talk about humanity. Because our laws change, and our political movements change. But compassion is always going to look the same.
Ow!
And just to close, thank you so much to everybody who came out today to support us. And I just want us to repeat it. Seeking asylum is not illegal. Seeking asylum is not illegal. Seeking asylum.